Joining us now for analysis of last night's debate is Philip Crowther, international affiliate reporter for the Associated Press. Philip, welcome back to the broadcast. Last night was the first time moderators asked about abortion. Why do you think it took so long to get to that issue, and should we expect abortion questions to be included in future debates?
You know, that's a very interesting question. I think there is a reason, of course, why these debates are happening in places like here in Westerville, right in the center of a battleground state like Ohio. Especially in a battleground state like this one, the issue of abortion is particularly important. It brings mixed reactions. Of course, it divides the political spectrum, not necessarily across party lines between Republicans and Democrats. So it was only a matter of time before those questions would be asked. You also heard from the former Vice President Joe Biden on stage giving another reason why maybe here in Ohio might have been the right time to bridge those questions for the first time, because he mentioned the two Planned Parenthood clinics had closed over recent weeks here in Ohio. That is another main reason. So we heard from almost all of the candidates, most of whom, certainly from Republicans' points of view, would have held pretty extreme views on abortion. That would certainly be the views of the president, for example, in the White House, but Republicans generally as well. Our first chance, then, to hear from all of those 12 candidates on stage on that very difficult issue that we do expect to come up again and again.
Last night, this was also the first debate since the impeachment investigation into President Trump began. How did the candidates address that impeachment issue?
Yeah, things have really changed, haven't they, since the last debate a month ago. Since then, we now know that all candidates, including those 12, a record number, who were on stage yesterday here in Westerville, they all are for that impeachment inquiry into the president. They all said pretty clearly on stage that they do want the president to be impeached. So that has certainly changed, but didn't necessarily dominate the debate here in Ohio, despite what we might have expected. Here's another element that we thought might be really important in this debate. For the first chance, we thought foreign policy might be the dominating theme because of what happened over the last few days, because of that Turkish incursion into northeastern Syria facilitated by the departure of U.S. troops from that same area. There were a lot of questions asked on that, but it certainly didn't dominate the debate. It did lead, though, to very forceful criticism of President Donald Trump by pretty much all candidates on stage, maybe with the notable exception of Representative Tulsi Gabbard from Hawaii. Maybe the strongest attacks on President Trump coming from former Vice President Joe Biden, but also from Mayor Pete Buttigieg of South Bend. He, of course, who has combat experience in Afghanistan.
Several moderate candidates went after Elizabeth Warren. Was it effective, and how did she handle it?
Well, you know, she did pretty well there. One conclusion that we can come away with from this debate is that Elizabeth Warren looked a little bit more like a front runner than she ever has. She is pretty much the joint front runner right now with former Vice President Joe Biden. And she seemed rather comfortable in that position, fending off attacks coming from all sides against her on her Medicare for All plan. Again, that is an attack that has come her way pretty much at every Democratic debate so far. But she is comfortable in this position, and it's maybe a sign of things to come over the next few months. Remember, this was only the fourth Democratic debate. There are eight more to come, and we are expecting quite a few candidates to fall by the wayside in time for the next debate that will be held in Georgia next month. And after those 12 Democratic debates, well, that's only when the two candidates, the two nominees, face off, with four further debates, including the one with the vice presidential candidate. Still a very, very long way to go. And that leading position that Elizabeth Warren, the senator from Massachusetts, seems to have right now, that could also still change quite a few times.
So many important issues that are brought up in this debate, ones we'll continue to follow. Philip Crowther, international affiliate reporter for the Associated Press, thanks so much.
Thank you.